And that right there is probably one of the most frustrating parts about playing Knights of the Old Republic. It's because it likes to crash unless you have it running specifically to what it deems appropriate. However, this will be a guide to simply get the game running so you can actually enjoy the content you paid for instead of sitting here and screaming at Steam for it not running. One of the first things, though, with Knights of the Old Republic 2 is that you should always remember this. If you can get it past this LucasArts screen, if you can get it past here and into the menu where you can actually start a game, that is a victory in itself. If you're stuck and you can't even get it this far, there are some fixes for that, too. But if you can get it this far, most likely, you're running your options too high. You're running your graphics too high. You need to go into here, hit the advanced options, and basically go around and drop things. You can play around and get it to the best you can, but I advise you to go here and drop the graphic texture qualities, everything. Try to drop it the lowest you can, and see if you can get the game to run. You can get the game to run. You can always try to boost it up and see if it'll go even higher than that. That's the first trick of the trade, is to simply come here and to adjust your graphics setting to see if you can get it to even run. The second trick of the trade is to depends on what kind of computer you're running and everything. If you're running a computer using integrated software from Intel, you might want to consider going and checking out a driver update by Intel instead of using your laptops or desktops drivers that came with it. Going to Intel's site, they have a driver utility that can tell you exactly what you're running for it. This driver update utility will go through your computer, find out exactly what you need, and it can update it there for you. However, if you're running a laptop, it's likely going to say no, because your OEM, or the laptop producer, has put in certain drivers for the laptop, and it doesn't want to change that. However, you're quite fine in downloading the Intel's drivers from their download center after finding out what you're looking for. This is found on the download center here, and you can find exactly your processor where you can use it to find the exact drivers you need for your computer so that you can possibly run this game. I know this works with an Intel HD 4000, for that was my laptop, and I discovered this fix after trying to get the game to run on my laptop. There is, however, the chance that this will not work. Now, in this case, this annoying factor, there is another workaround that can most likely will work for Intels and for other things, and that is to run the game in window mode. If you look around on the internet, you will find many options and things to run this in Windows mode. I advise you to read these and to find out exactly what to do. I don't run mine in Windows mode because I already got mine to work, and I have many hours on the game, and I thoroughly enjoy it. And that is all I can do to help you with getting this game to run. I understand it's frustrating and you're kind of annoyed, but remember, if you try these things first, then you're most likely going to at least get it to be running on your computer. It might be annoying that you have to do this, but hey, if it works, it works. And specifically, since these fixes really just affect the game itself, minus the driver updates, but those help you in general anyways. This will be a benefit to everyone, will benefit for you and everyone else that uses that computer. Now, when you get into the game, you will run across a bunch of annoying glitches here and there. The main annoying glitch is actually in the plateau. Sorry for spoilers. There's a plateau. That's about it, I will say. There are some mods that actually fix this for you. The main one is TSL RCM. I advise you to use this, but if you want to experience vanilla game, then don't bother with it. Just when you get there and you get stuck, make sure you save often, load up a previous save, and follow the internet's instructions exactly what to say at a certain point. And you'll never have a problem with it after that. You might say, well, it worked fine in the console version, so why is it stuck here? Well, it's an annoying glitch specifically for the PC version. Anyways, thank you for watching. I hope you have a good day.